From manufacturing plants to local businesses and hospitals, safety guarding is everywhere. Most guards are made to fit one specific area, which can make it challenging to find one that's adjustable and fulfills your specific needs for safety. In this segment of Xtreme DIY, we're going to build a modular and durable safety guard. It can be used in machine guarding, workplace barriers, sneeze guards, safety shields, and much, much more. Now, the panel in this guard is interchangeable between your choice of wire mesh and acrylic. 80/20 guards are custom made to fit any size, but in this project, we've narrowed it down to two size options of 2 foot wide and 3 foot wide. So let's get started. You may be asking, what do I need for this build? For the frame, we wanted something strong and durable, so we chose the 1515 ultralight smooth profile. With any T-slot profile, it'll make it easier to reconfigure the application or add on new components later on. Next, we need to choose our panel. We recommend either acrylic or thermoplastic coated wire mesh panel options for our safety guards. Acrylic panels are able to withstand repeated cleaning and absorb impact of flying debris. Typical guards use polycarbonate, but acrylic reduces the chance of scratches while cleaning. Wire mesh panels are abrasion and chemical resistant, while also being cost effective. Now it's time to build. Tools you'll need to get started are a 1/4 and 3/16 L or T-handle hex wrench. We'll start building the guard by preloading the 4-hole flat plates, floor mount base plates, and mesh retainers with bolts and T-nuts. Next, begin assembling the frame by attaching 2 flat plates and mesh retainers to each side profile. Now connect 1 floor mount base plate to the bottom of each profile. This will help us stabilize our guard by securing it to the floor. Then we'll lay out 1 side profile and install 3 cross supports using 2-inch socket head cap screws. Finally, we'll insert the panels and cap off the frame by attaching the other side profile. To secure the panels from moving in the T-slot, use panel gasket for acrylic panels, or connect mesh retainers with a backing plate on mesh panels. If you want to connect multiple guarding sections, you can use preloaded flat plates to attach the side profiles of 2 sections together. While these are options we've chosen, any part of this design can be modified to fit your specific needs. For example, you can add a door or safety components, like sensors or switches. So hopefully you found this segment of Xtreme DIY helpful. To download the project plan and design files, or even get started designing your own safety guard, please visit 8020.net. And as always, make it a great day.